MCQ solutions 11 to 20. First question. Which of the following is an independent bone? The options are cribriform plate, inferior nasal concha, middle nasal concha, or superior nasal concha. The answer is inferior nasal concha, just because rest of the three options belong to the ethmoid bone. Let's see in this video. So here this is a separate ethmoid bone, and when you see it from above on either side of the crista galli, you can clearly see the cribriform plate, and when you see it from below, you will clearly make out superior and middle nasal concha. So cribriform plate of ethmoid plus superior and middle nasal concha are part and parcel of ethmoid, whereas this is the inferior nasal concha. It is a separate bone, and this you can see in skull from in front through piriform aperture of the nose. See over here, it is found along the lateral wall of nose. So these are the inferior nasal concha, whereas superior and middle nasal concha plus cribriform plate of ethmoid is part and parcel of ethmoid bone. So our answer is inferior nasal concha. Second question. In mastoiditis, which of the following dural venous sinuses is more likely to be affected? The options are transverse sinus, superior petrosal sinus, inferior petrosal sinus, or sigmoid sinus. The answer is sigmoid sinus, just because when you see the cranial cavity over here in this video, the superior petrosal sinus is found along the superior border of the petrous temporal bone, see over here, whereas the inferior petrosal sinus is found along the posterior-inferior border along the basio occiput, whereas the transverse sinus will be found along the transverse sulcus. These are found along the squamous part of the occipital bone over here, whereas the sigmoid sinus is found along the sigmoid sulcus, and it is found in relation to the mastoid process. So this is sigmoid sulcus, and when you see it from in front, from lateral aspect, you can see the mastoid process. So deep to mastoid process, you will find sigmoid sulcus and sigmoid sinus. So similar thing you can appreciate in separate temporal bone. Okay, so our answer is sigmoid sinus, which will be affected in mastoiditis. Next question. A patient experiences numbness in the skin on the anterior aspect of the scrotum after herniorrhaphy. Which nerve would have been lesioned? The options are ilioinguinal, iliohypogastric, pudendal, femoral, or obturator. The answer is ilioinguinal, just because in this diagram you can clearly see the different areas of the skin are coded with different colors, and over here you can see this is the anterior one third of the scrotum, and that is supplied by ilioinguinal nerve plus genital branch of genitofemoral nerve. Particularly the ilioinguinal nerve is found within the inguinal canal. It pierces the posterior wall of inguinal canal and traverses within the inguinal canal. It runs along with the spermatic cord and emerges out through superficial inguinal ring to supply the skin along the anterior one third of the scrotum. So during herniorrhaphy, when there is a repair in posterior wall of the inguinal canal, there are chances of damaging this ilioinguinal nerve. So our answer is ilioinguinal nerve. Fourth question. Internal iliac artery was compressed by a mass at its branch point from common iliac artery. To maintain adequate arterial supply, which of the following structures will not require collateral circulation? The options are uterus, corpus spongiosum, testis, urinary bladder, or prostate. The answer is testis, just because it is supplied by a direct branch from aorta, whereas remaining four options are supplied by branches of internal iliac artery. So again, in this diagram you can clearly make out that this is aorta and it gives testicular artery, and that will supply testis. So even if the block is over here at the internal iliac artery from its commencement, so the testicular artery will bypass that block and will not require collateral circulation. So our answer is testis. Fifth question. After giving obstetric nerve block, it resulted into urinary incontinence. The muscle which is anesthetized would be found in. The options are superficial perineal pouch, pelvic diaphragm, trigone of urinary bladder, urogenital diaphragm or external genitalia? The answer is urogenital diaphragm, just because in obstetric nerve block we need to block pudendal nerve, and over here there is urinary incontinence. That means voluntary control of urine is affected, and that is maintained by sphincter urethral muscle, which is supplied by pudendal nerve, and that is found in urogenital diaphragm. So the muscle sphincter urethral will be found in urogenital diaphragm. The same thing you can appreciate in this diagram. So this is the deep perineal pouch or urogenital diaphragm, and within which we will find sphincter urethral muscle as well as deep transverse perinei muscle. So over here the question belongs to the sphincter urethral muscle, so the answer is urogenital diaphragm. Sixth question: carcinoma of body of pancreas is diagnosed via CT scan. Situated immediately posterior to the body of pancreas, which of the following blood vessel will likely to be compressed? The options are portal vein, splenic vein, abdominal aorta, renal vein, or splenic artery. The answer is splenic vein, just because in this diagram you can clearly make out that behind body of pancreas there runs splenic vein. So if there is a carcinoma of body of pancreas, immediately posteriorly oriented structure to body of pancreas will be splenic vein. So our answer is splenic vein. Seventh question: in a penetrating ulcer of the posterior wall of first part of duodenum, which of the following vessel is likely to be eroded? The options are gastroduodenal artery, celiac artery, proper hepatic artery, common hepatic artery, or anterior inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery. The answer is gastroduodenal artery, which is situated just behind first part of duodenum. See in this diagram, you can clearly make out this is first part, second part, third and fourth part of duodenum. This is portal vein, this is bile duct, and this is celiac trunk with its branches. This is common hepatic, this is the proper hepatic artery, and this is gastroduodenal artery. Along with the bile duct and portal vein, these three structures are running behind first part of duodenum. So our answer is gastroduodenal artery. Eighth question: a traumatic injury lacerates penile urethra in a young male patient and urine starts extravasation. Apart from perineum, where else it will spread? The options are anterior thigh, ischioanal fossa, rectovesical pouch, anterior abdominal wall, or deep perineal pouch. The answer is anterior abdominal wall. Now over here in this diagram you can clearly see it is shown as the ruptured penile urethra, and you can see the extravasated urine. So this will be the territory of superficial perineal pouch, and this is the commonest site of rupture of urethra within the bulb, and you can see that this space is continuous underneath the scrotum, around the penis, and in lower anterior abdominal wall deep to the fascia scarpa. So whenever there is rupture of urethra in the superficial perineal pouch, the urine will extravasate apart from perineum to the subcutaneous tissue of scrotum, penis, and lower anterior abdominal wall. If it is deep extravasation somewhere over here, then the urine can extravasate in extraperitoneal connective tissue. Now it won't go into the anterior part of the thigh, just because in this diagram you can clearly see the membranous layer of superficial fascia is firmly adherent to the underlying structure along this dotted line, and particularly along the anterior aspect of the thigh you can clearly see that this is the Holden's line extending from pubic tubercle laterally up to 8 cm. So this Holden's line won't allow the urine to extravasate into the anterior aspect of the thigh. So our answer is the urine from superficial perineal pouch can easily extravasate into the lower anterior abdominal wall deep to the membranous layer of superficial fascia or fascia scarpa. Ninth question: apart from bicornuate uterus, which of the following will show a defect secondary to failure of fusion of Mullerian ducts? The options are ureters, upper part of vagina, labia minora, vestibule, or urinary bladder. The answer is upper part of vagina. Over here in this diagram you can clearly see these are developing gonads. mesonephric duct, and these are the paramesonephric duct. When they fuse in the lower part, that is termed as uterovaginal canal. So obviously it will develop into uterus and upper part of the vagina when it comes in contact with urogenital sinus. So the derivatives of paramesonephric duct in females are fallopian tube. Over here you can see the uterus and upper part of vagina. So our answer is upper part of vagina. 10th question. While doing surgery of femoral hernia, which of the following structures will be found just lateral to the hernial sac? The options are sartorius muscle, femoral artery, femoral vein, femoral nerve, or adductor longus muscle. The answer is femoral vein. Over here you can see this is the femoral sheath and its three compartments. The medialmost compartment is the femoral canal, and its upper margin it is the femoral ring, which is bounded by lacuna ligament. So the femoral hernia will traverse through this, and this will be the neck of the sac, and somewhere over here will be the femoral hernial sac. So it will be within the femoral sheath in the medial compartment, and just lateral to the hernial sac will be the intermediate compartment of femoral sheath containing femoral vein. Over here you can appreciate in the intermediate compartment. So lateral to the hernial sac you will get femoral vein. So our answer is femoral vein.